Hi, today I'm going to make moss rose, a very pretty and colourful flower. Our materials required are crepe paper in a bright orange, white, peachish colour, pink or any floral colour, and green. This is some cotton wool and a thin wire. All the measurements are in centimeter. This is a stencil for a stamen. This is 1.5 by 4 centimeters long strip. Cut one piece. This is a strip for the petal. This is 2.5 by 15 centimeters. Cut one piece. This is of the bud. This is 1.5 by 1.5. And this is for the leaf. This is 3 centimeter wide strip. Cut as long as you want. First, take the strip for the leaf. So you can have it as long as you want, because that depends on how many leaves you want to make. And then just fold the strip twice. And cut out shapes like this. So they should not be more than 2-3 millimeters wide. Like this. This way you can have a lot of leaves like this. Cut a piece of thin wire. This is about 7 centimeters long. You can take slightly less or more. Now take some cotton wool, very little. Take the wire, apply glue on one end. And just put the cotton wool on it. Like this. Now take the piece for the bud, stretch it, apply glue. Just pinch the top so you get a pointed end while you're twisting. Like this. Then I've cut a strip from the peach colored paper. This is like, you know, it doesn't have to be red. It's between red and pink. So take any color that you have. And I've cut slightly more than half a centimeter wide strip. Stretch it. Apply glue at the back. So cover half the bud like this. Like so. Then you take these leaves one by one and attach them like so. So the base of the leaf is going beyond the bud because we don't want such a big leaf. So initially just attach leaves like this. And now you can attach leaves at the base. So put them in a circular form. Like this. Now just open out the leaves. So this is how this will look. Cut a piece of thin wire. This is about 15 centimeters long. Now I have cut a strip. This is about 1.5 centimeters wide, and you don't need the whole strip basically. So just first make fine cuts about 1/2 centimeter long, and 6 of them, and then cut off the piece like this. So this is what we have. Now just curl it. Apply glue on the base and stick it on this thin wire. Like this. Now I'll make the same kind of cuts on the strip, on the stamen strip, same way. So I'll just apply glue on this also. And stick it just below the curve of the stigma. And roll it at the same place. So this is what it looked like. Take the strip for the petals, fold it in half, and then half again. Cut out the fold, leaving a little gap on the other side. Don't cut it entirely. Now divide the strip into three parts. So like this. Now just cut off the corners, giving it a curved shape like this on both sides. Like this. Now just open out one fold, you still have this, and give a little kind of a dip. Like this. So I'll just do it. like so. So after cutting the strip, this is how it will look. Now just stretch each petal carefully. So it sort of cups like this. Now apply glue on the base. Take the center and just stick it like this, slightly above the base of the center. So just give a crimp between each petal as you go around the center. A little fold. Just press them hard so it sticks well, like this. Again, take this strip of peach colored strip, just stretch it. Apply glue. First, just start winding it at the base. So just complete one circle like this. And in the same way as we did for the bud, so apply attached leaves, but this time you don't need to extend them. So attach 2-3 leaves, sorry, 5-6 leaves at the base of the flower. Come down a bit and then start attaching leaves in the same way as I did for the bud on the stem. So now you can give gaps as you wind. This can happen, the strip can break off because of the glue. That doesn't matter. Now I'll attach the bud. So just put it next to it. Keep a wind it a bit. And then go on attaching leaves. So I'll do the whole. So now just open out the flower first, petal by petal. Just open it. If any petal is folded, just open it with your fingers. And then the leaves. This is how a little sprig of Portulaca would look.